Ahoy, this is Zdenka. When this camera, Canon M6 Mark II, came out last year, it was quite a disappointment for many people because it was lacking filming feature 24 frames per second. Now everything has changed. Canon finally came out with the promised firmware update. Now the camera films at 24 frames per second. And on top of that, this camera now is climbing the charts when it comes to top recommended vlogging cameras in 2020. I bought this camera when it just came out, and to be honest, I didn't use it that much because I was also waiting for that firmware update. I really wanted those 24 frames per second. Now that it's here, it's a game changer. New here, welcome. My name is Zdenka Darula. If you want to learn how to take better photos and videos with the latest gear and possibly participate in creative camera challenges, consider subscribing. I love using Canon M50 as it is simple and great for beginners, and I used it for 2 years and I will still use it as my backup camera and whenever I need to use two cameras at the same time. And for Canon M50 users, all features are the same, so don't worry, all the tutorials I'm gonna be making here still apply to you. So what changed on Canon M6 Mark II? Let's look at the menu. First we have 4K in 30 frames per second and 24 frames per second. There is no crop in 4K, unlike Canon M50. That one has a crop. Next is Full HD or 1080p at 60 frames per second, 30 and 24. And lastly, there is HD or 720p in 60 frames per second. In the menu, you can also select slow motion, 120 frames per second, and that one is in Full HD or 1080p. On Canon M50, it is only HD, which is 720p. The main reason for this upgrade is quality. Once I actually update my computer as well, I'm gonna be filming all the videos on this channel and also publishing them in 4K. I also sell stock footage. As we know, especially these days, it is very important to create a spider web of different revenue streams. Actually, most of the B-roll I film here, most of the footage goes to stock agencies. Let me show you all accessories which make this Canon M6 Mark II vlogging kit. The screen doesn't flip out like on Canon M50, and if you put a microphone on top, you're not going to see yourself on the screen. So I got this heavy-duty small rig cage. They have small one too, just to attach microphone, but I actually like all those holes here, as I can attach light or external monitor, just more options for the if I ever need it. And bonus, I don't have to carry coins in my pocket anymore because it's got this key you just screw it with, and then when you are done, it's magnetic, you just snap it back. Microphone I chose is this Mauki MC-M1. I wanted to try it out because it is half size of the other microphone I have. I have also Rode. I like the fact that it already came with the furry thing called Dead Cat, which is so good when it is a little bit windy outside. It will partially block the sound. It also came with two cables, one for your camera and another one for smartphone in case you want to use it with both. The other microphone I use, Rode, doesn't come with Dead Cat and it doesn't come with the extra smartphone cable. So with the small rig cage, you can attach a microphone here or you can attach it over there. So now when I attach it and flip out the screen, I can see myself. One more thing I want to say about the flip out screen, that when I'm filming B-roll and I'm not using microphone and the screen is up like this, it is awesome. When I was filming with the Canon M50 for last 2 years and the screen was flipping out to the side, I could never get used to looking sideways like this. It just didn't feel natural. As soon as I started filming with this and the screen was going up, it felt so much better. And I know that a lot of Canon M50 users will defend the Canon M50, and that's okay. I'm just sharing my personal thoughts, whatever I was feeling when I was using it for the last 2 years. Next thing you're going to need for vlogging is GorillaPod. I have this one for the last 2 years and it's still great. You can bend the legs and you can attach it to anything. There are many of those GorillaPods available on the market. Just don't go with the cheapest one because I heard from a lot of people that they break faster. it will be carrying your very expensive camera. So last thing you want to drop the camera. For daytime strong light outdoors filming, you also want to use variable ND filter. It works like sunglasses and it will also allow you to film with low aperture to get the sweet blurry background. And I have created a video about variable ND filter and what it can do in past. I'll link it below in the video description. For nighttime vlogging, it's a good idea to have one of these in your camera bag. Those are small LED lights, which are actually quite powerful. I prefer Falcon F7 as it is stronger, but you can dim it too, has a lot of effects, and it is magnetic. You don't have to always have it on your camera, you can attach it to anything. The magnet is very strong. To attach it to this cage, you also need this mini bean grip. And that is the basic vlogging kit for Canon M6 Mark II. I have listed all the items in the video description below in case you want to check out the pricing. They will be shown in your currency based on where you live. Hit the thumbs up if you found this video useful and don't forget to subscribe to all future videos. If you have any questions, comments, simply want to say hi or ahoy, you can do so in a comment section below. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao, ahoy.